It's winter time here in Farmville, USA. Farmers all over the nation have completed harvest and are hunkering down for the winter. But what does that mean, hunkering down for the winter? Do farmers really take a vacation this time of year? Or is it perhaps one of the most busiest times of the year? Well, we're going to answer that question here on Ag Ed. I'm Jared Adamson, and this is my job, teaching you about agriculture.
Here on Ag Ed, we travel from farm to farm to learn what it really means to be a farmer.
Either it's no good, or I put the wires on backwards.
There are good days, and there are bad days.
Is it a little better?
No, it's about the same.
There is bad weather, and there is good weather. No matter the circumstance, farmers do what they do to help feed the world.
Man, it's nice and cold out here on this winter day. It's the 1st of December, and I get to ride along with Jonathon, who works with Searle Farms. And here he is. My ride is just about here. It's a beautiful day to be alive. Well, now I'm inside the Peterbilt here. Nice big semi truck where Jonathon here is hauling some barley. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Some barley. Where are we taking this barley, Jonathon? Oh, we're taking it down to Pasley's. Is it going to, what's it going for?
Cattle feed?
Seed.
Seed? Oh, this is seed, seed barley.
Whatever it wants to be.
Whatever it wants to be.
You
see, that's the kind of attitude I like to see in farmers today. You know, it's just laid back, I do what I do, and make the money. Jonathon, if you had one word to describe your job, what would it be?
A job.
A job.
I like it.
You like it?
Yeah, because you're not always in the semi, sometimes you're in tractors.
Yeah.
They treat me good.
Is that one of the benefits of working in agriculture?
Oh yeah, favorite thing, you never know what you're going to do, and that's, like, we have plans, me and Hammer thinking, like, we're going to be servicing trucks, but if we always end up going and do something else, and that's what we enjoy, is just never knowing what you're going to do next.
Yeah, that's cool. It's one of the benefits of agriculture. You know, you never get bored with what you do. Now we wait. We made it here to the grain elevator. And that's what we do when we're bored.
Oh, mine won't go back up.
Hold on. Hold on. I got you, man.
Oh, all right, all
right. Take this, and you're going to have to hold your button up.
Okay, hold it up. Oh, hey, there we go.
Oh, after I take the air out, you gotta pull it up.
All right, Jonathon, what's the longest you've ever waited in line?
At Pasley's or somewhere else?
At Pasley's.
Back 2.5 hours.
2.5 hours.
They're pretty quick. Oh, sort of.
What's the longest you've ever waited?
at Pacific on spuds, probably like 6 or 7. One of the belts broke. There's like 3 trucks ahead of me. Yeah, it was a bad day.
Alright, right now, we're offloading the truck. See, we got the barley coming out the back. This would go down and get sucked into some augers, where it is then lifted up to some other, some holding bins. It's pretty dusty.
There's 2 red folders. One says green, one says potatoes.
Yeah. Okay, down here we got 2 red folders. Oh, and this is our grain hauls folder. See that? Grain hauls. I'm going to put this invoice right there. Yeah, I'm part of agriculture is keeping good records. That's what this is for. Well, that was a good good work, man. Job well done.
Yep.
Well, another day done. Another load gone. And Jonathon's check is in the mail.
It's not in the mail. I have to go pick it up.